Hey there, everybody, and welcome back to Vinyl Talk with Tavis. And I'm Tavis. This is one of those rambling drive videos. I'm going to make this commute to work. Pray for me. Every day. Between 35 to 45 minutes, depending upon traffic and depending on how early I get up. School is tomorrow. Okay, listen. Since this is Vinyl Talk with Tavis, okay, this is the last day to work in my classroom. I got some news about that. I'm going to take some records with me to play, because I like to play my vinyl while I'm working in the classroom. Okay, this is Ella Jenkins, Nursery Rhymes. I think I've showed this before, but I'll be using this in my classroom for the kiddos. Let's see. Listen, I bought 2 copies of Janet Jackson's Rhythm Nation, her reissue, the double LP set. So I have this one to take to class, and the other one I have at home that is sealed. So I'll be taking this to and from work if I want to listen to it at work. And I'm taking my Paul Davis, my VCLT from Mike. I'm taking my Amy Grant from Mike. I'm in the disco mood too. So I'm taking Disco Nights. I showcased this earlier. It has all those great hits from the disco days. Yeah, so here we go. And I like to watch the vinyl douche, Sam. I don't know if he's watching this, but I finally figured out what a meat stick was. Man, Brother Sam, the vinyl douche, he kept talking about a meat stick in his introduction, and I had no clue what he was talking about. I said, is he giving out innuendos? He says you can have a meat stick. I wasn't sure. Then I was talking to some of my friends, and they said, Tavis, we were at Walmart. He said, this is a meat stick. I said, oh, okay. So I'm having my little breakfast before going to work. I know it's not healthy. I got up too late. One thing about going back to school, if you're a teacher, is that you have to get up early. Listen, you cannot be a person that likes to wake up late and be a teacher. A meat stick and orange juice. During the summer, I wake up 9 and 10 o'clock. When school starts, and with this morning commute, 5:30. Then I have to meet the traffic after school. We get out at 4. We have to leave about 4:45, between 4:30 and 4:45. I'm not sure when we actually are supposed to be clocked out. But I usually leave about 5. And then I meet that traffic. Everyone's trying to get home. So that 45 minute drive can turn into, let me start driving. What am I doing talking? I can talk. I talk a lot, y'all. That 45 minute commute going back home can turn into an hour and 15 minutes. I'm sure that people have longer commutes than that. But it gets really old really fast. So this, talking to you, helps my commute to be much more smooth. My 23rd year of teaching. Mm, mm, mm. It's not that I never would have thought that 23 years would have come so soon. But wow. I don't feel like it's been that long. I've done some wonderful things. Okay. So, that bulletin board. Sorry for the different lighting, you all. That bulletin board that I was telling you about. The music has no borders. And I use using vinyl to for the border. Well, I posted that picture. I posted a picture of that bulletin board on my Instagram page. And one of the people, one of my followers, said, well, they posted, wouldn't it be so symbolic if that bulletin board were to fall down? And sure enough, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, friends, vinyl community, anyone listening to me, that border failed. I walked in the classroom yesterday. No, the other day. Man, I look different. All these different colors. I tell you, life. Okay. So, I went to my classroom and that border had fallen. Everything had fallen. The records were down on the sink. I said, I'm through with this border. I'm through with this bulletin board. I should have taken a picture of it, but I was so disgusted and upset about it because I had to redo the whole bulletin board. It's a big one too. So we have to go to the teacher's room and get butcher paper, which they're on big rolls, and we have to roll out the length of the bulletin board and cut it and carry it to the classroom and then staple it or tape it to the bulletin board and then put border around it to make it look nice and then put our message that we want to portray to the kids. It could be a quote or some type of content that you want to teach the kids. But this is a big bulletin board. You all, I have a dentist appointment today. I'm getting the second part of my crown done. Every time I go to this dentist, every time I go to the dentist in this area, there's a different dentist. I apologize for the lighting. I look like I'm suntanned. Not bad. Every time I go to this dentist, there's a new dentist and new people. Constant change. When I was a little boy, same dentist all the time. Now, every time I have any type of dental procedure done, a cleaning or something, a new dentist, new people. Hello, who are you? Like, hello, who are you? Anyway, why do dentists talk to you when they have their hands in your mouth? Listen. I was talking to one of a colleague of mine. I said, I have to go to the dentist tomorrow. I'm just spitting. I talk too much. No, I don't. I love talking, but I talk a lot. Why in the world, when the dentist has his hand in your mouth, he wants to ask you a long, drawn-out question? I'm like, what in the? What the hell's going on here? Okay, so I'm sitting in the chair. This dentist, he's different. I told him I was a teacher and all that. Oh, that's wonderful, you know. All the pleasantries. That's a good meat stick. Okay. Sitting in the chair, and he has this strange, we all have our own way of speaking. He has a very strange speech impediment. At least that's what I think. So when he talks, sometimes I don't know what he says. You all get over this light. I'm barely making it myself. That's why I have these shades on. So he's talking to me, and he says, you know, open your mouth so I can see, blah, blah, blah. And he's starting this crown procedure, and he wants to numb my gum. And he puts that needle in there. While he's talking to me, he kind of, he does it in the sly. So I don't know what's going on. All of a sudden, I see this big old long needle going in my throat. Not in my throat, but right there. And I'm like, so he's talking to me. It's like, you okay? You okay? You okay? You okay? So then he starts drilling. And I told him this. Before he started drilling, I said, listen, I don't know if I told you all this. I said, listen, I'm a teacher, and when kids come to me, because they tell you all their business. If you're a parent and you have a child, and if you have business that you don't want to be told, just throw that out the window. Because they will tell everybody at school. My mama said to my daddy, just anything. So the kids, if they come to me and say, Mr. Minner, I'm scared. I'm like, why are you scared? Because I have to go to the dentist after school. And I don't like to hear the drill. Listen, those kids cannot receive any empathy or sympathy from me. Because I told that girl, I never will forget. I told her, I said, honey, listen, I understand exactly what you're talking about. Because I'm scared of those drills too. I could not give her any comfort. I couldn't fake it. And she was kind of crying a little bit. I said, baby, I understand. I don't like the drills either. When I hear that noise, it's like a teacher putting her fingernails against the chalkboard. It just makes me just cringe. I know what you're talking about, sweetheart. And she just kind of looked at me like, that's not what I was expecting to hear from you. But the next day, she ran to my classroom and she said, Mr. Minner, I got my tooth fixed. I'm like, oh, that's great. And then they want to show you. I said, listen, don't open your mouth, baby. Just go to class. It's going to be okay. The kids will show you everything. They will open up their mouth and just show you everything. I'm like, listen, I don't want to see your teeth right now. Oh, much better lighting. Okay, what else is happening? Back to school. So the border failed. Had to fix that border. You know, I've been seeing a lot of new vinyl community members who are very young. There's one that's called Eminem Vinyl. His name is Mason. How cool is that? How cool is that to have these youngsters showcasing or just owning vinyl, and they're talking about these classic artists? I think that is so cool. I'm floored. I'm just very excited to know that vinyl is still important to youngsters. And because of that, you know, it's going to be in demand even more. I had one person question me. I'm not sure what his name was or is. He said that he just got back into vinyl after watching my unboxing of my new turntable. And he said, wow, the vinyl records are very expensive. I'm like, yep, they are. If you buy the new ones and the very classic ones. But we still do it. I'm kind of through with collecting the cheap stuff. I like now getting the new reissues. I don't mind getting the new stuff if I can afford it. I do expect today or tomorrow to have Rick James in my hand. Not his actual body, but Rick James, the album called Throwing Down. Although his previous album, Street Songs, was considered much more popular. But I like Throwing Down. I like the song Dance With Me. The first song off that track, the first track off that album, that is a throwdown funk jam. I mean, I just love funk music. I love funky funk music, like George Clinton and Rick James. So what else is happening? I can surely expect that with going back to school, we're gonna have a lot of talk about our ways of dismissing kids if there's any shootings in the area or in our school. Can anybody out there who is in any form of politics, can you please talk to your people to please put some type of gun measures in place that can prohibit certain people from getting certain weapons? I just don't see why anybody would want to have a gun that's meant for war. Unless you are a soldier in war. I don't even own a gun. I've thought about getting one. But I'm not gonna get no AK-47. Did you hear about the story of the man who kept a gun in his baby's diaper bag? He was changing the baby and the gun went off. Look, I'm not sure. I'm sure I heard that story. I'm not sure what the outcome was. It's left my mind, but I think that is just ridiculous. Who in God's name would put a gun in a diaper bag and then have the audacity to have the diaper bag around the baby with the diapers in the diaper bag, changing the baby in the car? I tell you, this world, these people, I don't understand. And then you have people who don't even own guns and they're saying, we don't want no one to take our guns away. I said, do you own a gun? No. Then why are you worried about it? What's it to you? Child, get you a pistol and shut your mouth. Why do you have to have a big old AK-47 that shoots all these bullets within seconds? I like to go hunting. Well, look at you. That's great. Keep on hunting. Well, why in the world are you going to take an AK-47 and go hunting? If you're going to kill a deer, is it going to take 40 rounds to get it? By the time you get it, it's going to have so many bullets in it, it won't be eatable. Sorry, edible. You know what? That's just too much. I got to change subjects. I must change subjects. Listen, if you all are a subscriber of mine and you are for all this guns and to have AK-47, don't stop being a subscriber. Don't let that fool you. It's just people have different opinions and that's totally fine. Jesus, that sun. Yeah, we're going to talk a lot about how we're going to dismiss kids from the school buildings and where they should go if there's an intruder on campus and how, you know what? The teachers had a big gathering before school was out, before summer began, and we had a gathering. And we had to learn how to protect children if there was an intruder with a gun. And all the teachers gathered in the high school auditorium. And our superintendent spoke to us calmly. I love him. He's a great guy. And he said, I know that many of you maybe a little anxious about this, but it's something that we have to do. These are the signs, or these are the times in which we live. And because of that, we have to do this. So the police from the city came into the building, and we all went to separate rooms, and we were grouped in certain areas. And then we had a teacher who pretended to be our teacher, you know, and we sat there and we discussed what we were to do if we heard gunshots, or if the secretary or principal came over the intercom and began talking to us saying that there's an intruder. So we get in this room, at least in my group, and we hear these gunshots. I mean, there were teachers who had to take Xanax before they even went into the room. I'm sure some of them, look, I don't know. I heard that a few had to take something because it was very nerve-wracking. They had to have something to calm themselves down because some were having anxiety attacks. Because who wants to hear a gunshot as a teacher? That's the last thing you want to hear. So to think about the scenario of guns in the classroom. So we had to prepare ourselves, and we heard the gunshots, and they were blanks. And then one of the police officers comes to the door and shakes the door. And I mean, he's using some language, you know, let me in, you know. And so we have to stay as calm as possible. And we barricaded the door as soon as we heard the announcement on the speaker, and it was really something. So I'm sure our principal may talk to us about how we should really be prepared, even more so. It's not that we weren't prepared before, but even more so if it comes to an intruder on campus with a gun. Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, dear friends, 9 hours later, my work is complete. Summer is officially over. Well, not until the next few hours, because I'm going to get to my mailbox. I'm going to get the album that's waiting for me, my Rick James Throwing Down album, sealed from eBay. Man, I love eBay. Wow. eBay and Discogs. What great companies. Anyway, I'm going to listen to me some Rick James. I'm going to smoke me a cigar. I may go out and have dinner. Then again, I may not. Because I am tired. I am a tired man. Got all my bulletin boards together. I fixed that bulletin board that had fallen down. I did a little painting. I got the sign ready that says music class. My room is clean. All of us teachers, we're ready. We had some kindergartners come to visit us today. It's what we call the kindergarten roundup. So as many kindergartners who could come, they came to greet their teachers. Their parents brought them, and then the teachers took their particular students to their classrooms to visit the room and to learn about transitioning from the class to their specials class, and then they took them to the cafeteria to show them how they're going to be dismissed and where they're going to be sitting. You know, the first day of school is two words, fun and chaos. That's what the first day of school is, because half of the kids don't know where they're going. Because they're all in new classes, unless they were held back.
But they're like, where's Mrs. So-and-so? Where's Mr. So-and-so? Where's the bathroom? Where do I put my lunch pail? Where do I put my backpack? All types of questions. Lots of crying. Mama, don't leave me. Oh, heavens. 23 years. No, 22 years. This is my 23rd year. 22 years, I know. Mama, don't leave me. We had one of the most beautiful children today during the kindergarten roundup. She got lost, but she didn't know she was lost. She was just walking around, wasn't even scared. But she didn't speak English. And I speak a little Spanish. So they called me and said, Tavis, can you help this girl? She doesn't know what to do. And I said, ¿Cómo te llamas? And she said her name was Yamin. In English, it's Jasmine, but they say Yamin. At least that's what she said. And I said, okay. ¿Cómo te llamas? Last name. I don't know too much Spanish, but I know just a little bit to get by. I said, uno, Yamin, dos, ¿cómo te llamas? And she said, Perez. We could not find her name. So we finally found her mother. And her mother speaks a little English as well. And I said, is this your daughter? And she said, yes. I said, what is her name? Catherine. I said, does she have a middle name? Jasmine. I said, she's been seen. Yamin. And on the paper, on the roster for her teacher, it says Catherine. And she's saying Yamin. She said, oh. So we had to fix that. But she wasn't scared. She had me by my little, she had me by my finger. And we were walking through the hallway, talking to the teachers to see which teacher was hers. I'm glad she wasn't crying. I'm gonna need me some Rick James tonight. I can't wait to get home. Everybody, I'm going to turn off this camera and I'm gonna see you at the next go round. Well, everybody, I made it home. And in my mailbox was just what I was expecting. The thing that I needed to make my night fantastic, okay? I have been wanting this for a long time. It is an epic cover. You know what? Rick James was imitating the Rock and Rollers. Look at that. That's something that you probably see from Kiss or Led Zeppelin or Judas Priest. Man, he was doing his thing. This came from the year 1982. Now, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to unbox this. I don't like having the plastic on it. Dance With Me and Standing on the Top are my favorite songs, but I love every song on this album. And I'm going to talk to you about this album. Oh, well, there it goes. I just don't like having the plastic on my records. I'll sleeve them properly. I've got some sleeves coming, some outer sleeves. Man, this is sealed from 1982. Now, let me give you some history about this because I know about the 80s, okay? Man, when I was a boy, I just thought this was just titillating. Is that the word? Is it tintillating or titillating? You tell me. I don't know. It was just something to behold because my uncle or my aunt had this cassette and I would just look at the cassette. And I'm like, why is this man wearing braids with a shield and he's half naked and he has sandals on you know, as a child, I just didn't understand album covers that were so out there. You know what I'm talking about? And I would just look at them. And this was one of the albums that I would just stare at. When I go to record stores, I just stare at this record. But my uncles or my aunties had the cassette. I don't remember them having the album. I remember going to the record store and just looking at this. I would just hold it in my hands and I was like, what's going on? What is this? Who is this? And anyway, this is the second album, or this is the album that came after Street Songs. Okay? So Rick James did the album Street Songs, which had the song Super Freak. This album was not as popular as Street Songs. However, I personally like this album. It seemed to me that Street Songs was much more in the pop genre, you know. Super Freak, I mean, that's a great song. And all the songs on that record are awesome. But I enjoy this album. And someone had told me in previous comments, in some of the posts I made, that Street Songs is much better. And I respect that, you know, and I'm going to be getting that as well. But this, Dance With Me, and listen, okay. In 1981, when Rick James did his album Street Songs, he asked the Temptations to do the background vocals on Super Freak. Because you hear him distinctly say, Temptations sing, and you hear, oh, okay. So they're singing on that song. And his cousin is Melvin Franklin in The Temptations. That was his cousin. May they both rest in peace, Rick James and Melvin Franklin. And then in 1982, he does this album. And he's busy. Rick James is busy. He's producing and working on his album. And he's also working on the Temptations reunion album. And they all come, many of the Temptations come back together and they do this album and they do a reunion tour, okay? And the song or the album that he produces for the Temptations is called Reunion. The jam is Standing on the Top. So Rick James puts the edited version on this record. It's the shorter version. And then the longer version is on the Temptations album called Reunion. He puts Standing on the Top, the long version, on that album, the Temptations album. Does that make sense? Okay. So Rick James was doing his thing, y'all. And so this album is just, it means so much to me. And I'm opening, oh man, I never saw that. I'd never seen this before. Man, Rick James was something else. I mean, back then, this all seemed strange to me. It's so sexual and, you know, when you're 10 and 11, you're like, what in the world? Can you imagine kids these days looking at album covers of like Cardi B or what's that girl's name? It starts with the N. I don't know. I don't know these people these days. Look. If you told me what the top 10 records were of these days, I would have no clue. I'm so out of the loop. I enjoy the music that I know from my youth days. Okay? Anyway, but you know, in a sense, I am up to date because my students keep me up to date. But when I come home, I prefer what I love.
That's everyone. We all love what we love. Okay? So anyway, I've never seen this before. I think that's cool. The lyrics, okay? Let's see. Oh, this is from, is it called a subsidiary? A subsidiary of Motown. This is Berry Gordy, the founder of Motown, but he had a second company from Motown called Gordy Records, okay? And so Rick James was on that album. I think it's very important to say that when the Temptations came back together, when Rick James produced their album Reunion, which features the song Standing on the Top, they came back to Motown. That was a big deal back in 82, 83. That was a very big deal for the Temptations to come back together. Can you imagine all those egos? David Ruffin, Dennis Edwards, Melvin Franklin, Rick James's cousin, all the, many of the Temptations, they all came back together. That was a significant time. I remember it vividly. When Standing on the Top came out, we were like, damn, that's the jam. Of course, I didn't say it like that because I was too young to say cuss words. But now I can say, damn, that song is the jam. And you know what? Honestly, I prefer the edited version. I prefer this version, the shorter version. It's edited together so wonderfully. But I do want to get the Temptations reunion album. That's one of my next albums I want to get, either from Discogs or eBay. And I want it sealed. You all, I can't do a... This is a song I love. You know what? I hope I don't get in trouble. How do you all not get in trouble? There are so many of you out there who do needle drops. Do your videos get taken down because of that? Or do they consider you being supportive of that artist and they let you keep your video up, but you just don't have it monetized? I don't care about that. I just want to let the world know about this great music. I don't care about this video being monetized. I don't even have 1,000 subscribers yet. So please subscribe. You all are watching me. If you're watching me and you haven't subscribed and liked, please do. And if you don't like it, dislike it too. I like that feedback. I like it. Okay. This is Dance With Me from Rick James. I'm playing just a little bit of it. It's long, but I'm playing just a little bit. This song is the bomb. Thank you. That was cool. I pushed stop. Okay, you can't tell me that's not funky. That is a jam. Oh my God. Now, this is Standing on the Top with the Temptations. The first song on the second side, y'all, you need to get this record. If you like funk music and you don't have Rick James, I'm mad at you. Standing on the Top. With the Temptations. That's a jam. If you're standing on the top, let me hear you say hallelujah. Someone said, thank you, Jesus. I can turn any song into a gospel song. Oh, man, I'm excited again. I'm going to relax tonight, y'all. I'm so happy. Hey, with music. Be inspired and stay inspired.